Hello everybody. In this video, I'm going to talk about some monthly immigrant visa issuance statistics. I'm going to show you where you can check those and what it means for your case in the different consulates. We're going to go through Mumbai, we're going to go through Kabul, we're going to look at Madrid, go through Nigeria, Kenya, and a few other embassies, and I'll show you how you can check that for yourself. And also we'll talk about some current litigation that is now being launched against certain embassies and consulates, specifically Manila and Moscow. And the reason is because these particular posts are specifically not issuing K-1 fiancé visas and also have a significant backlog with immigrant visas. These litigations are specifically focused on the K-1 fiancé visa, and I know many of you are concerned about that and may want to hear that information. So I'll cover all this in this video, so make sure you stick until the end. So what are you waiting for? I'll see you on the other side. Hello everybody, and welcome to our immigration channel. This is the place where you get the most up-to-date immigration information, immigration updates, and everything else that you need to make your immigration journey less stressful. My name is Jacob Sapochnik, and I'm an immigration attorney located in San Diego, California. I help clients in all 50 states. If you're here for the first time, make sure to subscribe to our channel. Click the notification bell so you don't miss any of our videos, and also give us a big like so YouTube will be able to share this video with more people just like you. In this video, we're going to specifically talk about against the recent litigation that is now forming against the U.S. Embassy in Moscow, as well as the U.S. Embassy in Manila, specifically for delays in K-1 visa issuance. This is a major problem, and I've been talking about this in many other videos, and we've been fighting these consulates by trying to expedite our clients' cases. And we've definitely been successful, but there are hundreds of people that are still waiting for their appointments and they're still not able to reunite with their fiancés, and therefore there's a new litigation that is starting, and I'm going to talk about that. We'll also talk about monthly immigrant visa issuance statistics so you understand what's happening in different consulates and embassies around the world. So why are these lawyers suing the State Department, specifically the U.S. Embassy in Moscow and Manila, and what are they trying to achieve with this litigation? They'll be asking a federal judge to force the U.S. Embassy in Moscow and Manila to resume processing of K-1 visas in a timely manner. One of the State Department's official duties is to adjudicate visa applications and to actually issue visas. These embassies are not doing that at the moment. They are saying that 60 days processing time is normal to adjudicate those K-1 visas, but in many cases it's not true, and it's taking definitely much longer for this to happen. If you look at many other agencies like USCIS, CBP, and Labor Department, they've most of them adjusted to all the delays of COVID-19 by getting more people on board, by changing the way they process their cases, and they were able to continue processing cases without severe backlogs. The State Department remains the only agency that has not moved forward and continues to accumulate backlog day in, day out. Not only the State Department has made no changes, they're not indicating what exactly they're going to be doing to make the situation a little bit different. So what kind of people should consider joining said litigation? I think that if you try to expedite your case first under the national interest exceptions and you fail, for example, in the Philippines we've seen in recent weeks definitely resistance, do have some success both in Moscow and Manila. We've definitely seen a lot of pushback in the past few weeks from both of these posts. And therefore, if your request to expedite has been turned down, you may want to consider litigating if you don't want to wait any longer. If your I-129 has been approved and your case is stuck at MVC, they're not pushing it to the embassy, and you've tried to expedite your case and you failed, you should consider joining the litigation. If your case is actually sitting in a consulate, but no interview has been scheduled, and you try to expedite, you try to use any of the national interest exceptions, they refused, you may want to join the litigation if you don't want to wait any longer. If your interview has been scheduled, but then it's been canceled at least once, and you were not able to get anywhere with the consulate, they don't respond to your emails, they're not willing to entertain any exceptions, you may consider joining a litigation. If you had an interview, but your case is now stuck in administrative processing, I definitely think you should consider litigating your case. Finally, your K-1 visa was issued, but because of the travel restrictions, you were not able to travel to the United States. Now your visa has expired. The embassy is not willing to reissue your visa. You definitely want to litigate if you haven't received any favorable response from the embassy trying to get your visa reissued. And in the monthly immigrant visa issuance statistic, you can see it's broken down by year and per month, and we can scroll down to see the current month they're processing. The most recent month they have online at the moment is March 2021. So let's take a look. So let's talk about Abu Dhabi. So you can see Abu Dhabi right now, March, they're processing CR1. They processed 29 CR1 visas. These are the conditional resident visas. Let's look at RI1 immigrant visas. They're processing 88. So again, as you can see, they're starting to, if you compare it to previous months, you can see that they are moving forward, which is good news. We have a lot of questions about Abu Dhabi, so I wanted to show you what they do in Abu Dhabi. Now let's look at Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. CR1s, 31 of them were issued in March, and IR1s, 125. As I mentioned before, Addis Ababa is definitely moving forward, and they're doing a good job with processing visas. Hopefully it will continue. Now let's look at Bogota. Bogota only processed 14 CR1 visas in March and 140 IR1 visas in March. Again, they are slowly reopening, and we can see some good movements in that embassy as well. Let's look at Cairo. Cairo, CR1 visas, they've issued 12 CR1 visas in March and 80 IR1 visas, immediate relative visas in March. So again, they are slowly reopening. Again, try to compare it to previous months, and you can see that there's a slow movement forward. We definitely want to see more from these embassies and consulates, but it's definitely happening. Let's look at Ciudad Juarez, Mexico. CR1, there's only 13 CR1s, and when it comes to IR1 visas, there's been more than 1,400 immediate relative visas issued. In the month of March, definitely one of the busiest embassies. We're going to see more movement from them in the next few months as well. Let's look at Lagos. Lagos CR1s. There's been 174 CR1s. That's been really good movement. As we mentioned, they've been pretty much open on a consistent basis. And IR1s 243, which is not bad. And people are asking me about F3 visas. From Lagos, has been only 14 F3 visas that were issued in March. Let's look at Europe. Madrid, CR1, we have 17 immigrant visas issued and 23 IR1s immigrant visas. So as you can see, very, very low processing capacity, and we need them to start moving forward. With Moscow, Moscow only issued 3 CR1 visas. As you can see, we don't have K1 statistics here because the K1s are considered to be non-immigrant visas, but you can see the trend from this embassy to essentially they issue 1 IR1 visa in March and 3 CR1 visas, which is a disgrace for this embassy. Let's look at Mumbai. Mumbai issued 400 CR1 visas and 400 IR1 visas. And they are doing an effort to keep pushing forward. Let's look at Manila, CR1s. We had 175 CR1s in Manila and 387 IR1 visas, immediate relatives, and only 3 F3 visas in Manila. Again, this post is still backlogged. There are thousands of people that are waiting to come from Manila, and these numbers are really, really low. So as you can see, you can do the link is in the description of this video. You can do the same for your embassy. You can go and take a look every month and track to see how many visas they're processing. But as you can see, some posts are definitely doing a good job and they have a nice healthy processing limit, but other embassies are literally stuck month by month, and that's why litigation is necessary sometimes to force them to do what they're supposed to do. As I mentioned, before litigation, we tried to expedite. We had our law firm had a very high success rate with national interest exceptions for almost every embassy in the world, and I do believe that it's a good step to start before you go litigate. But if all fails, I do believe that litigation can be effective, and it's not going to hurt you in any way. So once again, if you have any questions, post them in the comments below. Let me know what other videos you would like me to make. If you need help with your individual case to expedite or any other help, text me at 619-483-4549, and I'll be there to help you every single time. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.